Good evening, one and all. In the class, we have started with the continuous time Fourier series. For a periodic signal x of t, the continuous time Fourier series pair, it is defined as x of t equal to summation over k equal to minus infinite to infinite ck e power jk 2 pi by capital T into t. Here capital T is the fundamental time period, which is equal to 1 over the fundamental frequency, and ck is the Fourier series quotient, which is given by 1 over capital T integral over 0 to capital T x of t multiplied with e power minus j 2 pi by capital T multiplied with kt dt. This is harmonically related complex exponential functions. This is linear combination of harmonically related complex exponential functions. This ck, if you remember, we have derived this expression in the class using the orthonormality property of the complex exponential function. If I plot mod ck versus k, this is the absolute value of the Fourier series quotients. If I plot it with respect to the frequency index k, it gives us the magnitude spectrum. If I am going to plot the angle of the ck, which is given by tan inverse of the imaginary part of ck divided by the real part of ck, if I plot it with respect to k, then we call it as phase spectrum. In the class, we have solved this problem. We have considered x of t as a rectangular train whose duty cycle is given by t1 by capital T. Here t1 is 0.3 second and capital T is equal to 1 second. For this signal, we have derived the Fourier series quotients. We have obtained the Fourier series quotients. The Fourier series quotient is computed using this formula, and we obtained this as ck equal to capital T by t1 multiplied with e power minus jk pi multiplied with t by capital T1, and this multiplied with sine of k pi capital T by t1 divided by k pi capital T by t1. For the value of k equal to 0, this thing is going to become a 0 by 0 form, for which we have computed this expression explicitly, whose value came as capital T by t1. This we have already solved in the class. Now let us plot the values of ck with respect to k, I mean to say the magnitude spectrum and the phase spectrum separately, and let us see how they vary. And I want to reconstruct the signal with a truncated series. What is meant by a truncated series? I am going to use only fewer values of k instead of k equal to minus infinite to infinite. I am going to consider only 2nc plus 1 number of values in reconstructing the signal x tilde of t, where the actual signal x of t is reconstructed with k equal to minus infinite to infinite. So there will be definitely an error occurring because of this truncated series, which is given by the second norm of the difference of x of t and x tilde of t whole square. Now let us move on to the MATLAB simulation. I know that you are new to MATLAB, but the simulation is not to make you comfortable with MATLAB, but to make you understand the continuous time Fourier series. What I am trying to do in this simulation, first simulate the signal, which is your rectangular train, and then compute the Fourier quotients of it, then reconstruct the signal with fewer number of quotients. Vary the number of quotients and observe what is the error happening with different number of quotients. Let us first simulate the signal. Here capital T is initialized to 1. This is nothing but the time period of the signal. Capital T1 is the on period of the signal. It is on time of the signal. Capital Ts is sampling period of the signal I am considering. Why I need to sample here? Because MATLAB cannot handle continuous time signals. I am going to discretize the independent variable. So this is the sampling frequency I am considering as 1 over Ts, which is 10 kilohertz. Now capital N is equal to 5 I have initiated, and T is varying from minus NT to NT in steps of Ts. What is this minus N into T? This is minus 5 here and this is 5 here. So 5 periods towards the negative end and 5 periods towards the positive end I am considering, and the values are in going in steps of 0.0001. That means the initial value of T will be minus 5. The next sample immediate will be at minus 4.9999. Now, I want to consider exactly the same number of samples which will be present in this range. That is why I am removing the last sample. Now, I am initializing X with all zeros and I am checking if the time index of the there's a loop which is running over all the time indices. I am checking the time index if it is belongs to on time or not. If it is on time, I am making the signal is equal to 1. I am just dividing the sample number with the capital T by Ts. If it is in the range of 0 and capital T by Ts minus 1, then we will have the signal in the on period. This is not a big deal. This you can get it if you spend some time on this. Now I am plotting the signal. These are the commands used for plotting. So let us plot the signal. Let us run the program till here. So this is our input signal. You can see this is 0 here and this is 1. The signal is varying from minus 5 to 5 here and it is going in steps of 0.0001. Now why it is looking like a continuous time signal to me? I have not plotted it in discrete sense, but I have plotted this using the interpolation. What do I mean by that is, this is actually discrete points. MATLAB, what it does when I plot, it just connects two discrete points. So that is why it is looking like a continuous time signal to me. Actually, let me plot those points and show you. I'm just going to copy this here and I'm going to say plot it using this. I want to plot it in blue color and with stars and with a solid line. With a solid line. So let us see how this looks like now. So these are all the points we have. These are discrete points which are connected by line. That is why the signal is looking like a continuous time signal for us. So let us move on. Now the next step is to compute the Fourier series of the signal. Here I am computing the Fourier series of the signal and then I am reconstructing the signal with fewer number of coefficients, and I am considering different number of coefficients to see how the error is varying if I am considering different number of coefficients. So here you can see NC I consider it to be 1 first, then 3, then 5, then 10. So I am going to run over the loop for NC equal to 1 and then 3, so on till 300. Now what do I mean by NC equal to 1? I am taking the value of k to vary from minus 1 to 1. So it is going to have 3 coefficients. When I say NC equal to 3, that k is going to vary from minus 3 to plus 3. So the number of coefficients I am considering is 7. Likewise, when n is equal to 5, the number of coefficients will be 2 into 5 plus 1, which is 11. So that's how it will come and vice versa. Now let us move and see what we are doing here. I'm computing only the coefficients from minus 1 to 1 initially. So initially the value of NC is equal to 1. So here I'm computing only the values of the coefficients for the indices from minus 1 to 1. So this is where I am computing that, and I am plotting these coefficients, the magnitude of the coefficient and the phase of the coefficient. The magnitudes with respect to k is going to give me the magnitude spectrum, and the phase with respect to k is going to give us the phase spectrum. And then we are going to reconstruct the signal with these three coefficients and see how the reconstructed signal is going to look like, and how it is along with the, how does it look like along with the input signal. Okay, let us look at that. Let us run the program till here and see. So here what we have, this is the magnitude spectrum with only three coefficients. This is k equal to 0 and k equal to minus 1 and k equal to 1. You can see these three samples, and this is the phase at k equal to 0, k equal to minus 1, k equal to plus 1. And this is the reconstructed signal. The reconstructed signal with only three coefficients looks like this. So actually I should get a rectangular train if I am considering infinite number of coefficients, but because I considered only three coefficients for reconstruction, I got almost a sinusoidal signal, and this is the approximation we have. And the difference between these two signals will be the error. This figure is going to update. I wanted to show you the variation of the signal with a different number of coefficients. That's why I'm drawing it again. So we'll move and see what will happen if I'm going to increase the number of coefficients here. So this is what we have again. This is for n is k is varying from minus 3 to 3. So the number of samples used for reconstruction is 7. And here you can see it is the phase spectrum for the corresponding values, and this is the reconstructed signal. You can see the reconstructed signal is still not a rectangular pulse, but this is better than the previous signal what we got. The comparison of it is what I am interested in. So this is where you can see that comparison. This signal, which is in red, this shows you the reconstruction with k equal to minus 1 to 1, and the one which is in magenta, it is going to show you with k equal to minus 3 to 3. That means the red one with the three coefficients and the magenta one with 7 coefficients. So you can see that the error is small with k equal to minus 3 to 3, that means with 7 coefficients. Now let us move on to the more number of coefficients reconstruction. I will take next 2 into 5 plus 1, 11 coefficients. So these are the 11 coefficients, and in the class I have explained you that mostly the amplitude or the magnitude of the coefficients is going to decrease with respect to k. So although it looks like some variation is there here, but as the value of k is increasing, these coefficients are supposed to die down. And here also, this is the spectrum of the signal, and you can see how the reconstructed signal look like. This is the reconstructed signal with 11 coefficients, and you can also see near these discontinuities there are overshoots. This is nothing but the Gibbs phenomena that we discussed in the class. And again, the error is going to reduce with respect to the previous case. This is with 11 coefficients. The figure I want to see is figure 5. Yes, here you can see that the error with 11 coefficients is small. The one which is in cyan color, this color, is the reconstructed signal with 11 coefficients. So the error is small. The error is small with 11 coefficients. And you can also see that the overshoots are reducing in magnitude as the value of the number of coefficients we are considering is increasing. Now with more number of coefficients, when I consider nc equal to 10, I am going to consider 21 coefficients. So the result looks like this. This is the reconstructed signal. We can still see that this is not a rectangular train, but still the error got reduced when compared with the previous case that you can observe here, and the overshoots also got reduced. So I think this is the one with k equal to when nc equal to 21 coefficients. Here you can see that the overshoot is small and the error is also small for this particular signal. Let us move on to the next thing with the number of coefficients as 2 into 50 plus 1, which is 101 coefficients. The reconstructed signal is now almost looking like the rectangular train, but still you can see that overshoots, and the overshoots are high at the boundaries again, the Gibbs phenomena, right? So this is what we have, and we can see that the error got reduced. I'm plotting the same thing here as well. So the one with I don't know what color is that. I think we can call that as gold, so or yellow. Yeah, this is yellow. So the one with yellow color is with less error again, and the overshoots also got dampened. So let us move on to the next thing, and the next thing will have 201 coefficients. So the error still got reduced and the overshoots still got reduced. Let us actually look at the spectrum again, the magnitude spectrum and phase spectrum. You can see that now they are becoming a bit denser. So this is phase spectrum and this is supposed to be the magnitude spectrum. You can see the beautiful sync function here. This is the main beam, and as the value of k is increasing, this is going increasing and then decreasing, increasing and then decreasing. So but the point more I am interested in is that as the value of k is increasing, these coefficients are dying down. That means as the value of k is increasing, the error is going to reduce in the reconstructed signal. This is the phase spectrum. Let us move on with the 601 coefficients. This is what we have. This is still not a this is still not a rectangular train, but here it is almost approximated as a rectangular train with overshoots at the boundary. So this is what I wanted to show you for today. So the moral of the story is this: as the number of coefficients is increasing, the error in the reconstructed signal is going to decrease, and at the boundaries you will have more overshoots, which is called as Gibbs phenomena. And one more thing, as the value of k is increasing, the coefficients are going to die down. These are the three important points I want you to understand. So I'll stop it here.